24.
Psalm 24.
It's a period of prayers and waiting upon the Lord, and there are benefits for those that wait on the Lord. Verse 6 of Psalm 24, he said, this is the generation of them that seek thy face. This is the generation of them that seek thy face. This is the generation of them that seek thy face. Selah. Selah means pause and consider. Now, when he said this is generation, what was the generation he was talking about? That word, this is the generation that seek thy face. What it means is that when he put Selah behind, he was trying to say this is what will happen to the generation of those that seek thy face. So you go to the next verse, which is a lift up your heads, O ye gates, and be lifted the everlasting doors. We're going to pray concerning gates. Lift your head, O ye gates. Everyone that is great has a gate to fight. There is a man that stands to man the gate for your next level. Every great man has a gate man to confront. There is a gate that has been, that's imposing. Whenever God has said you're going to get access to greatness, there is a gate man that stands to say you can't cross. Am I communicating? A gate man. And don't forget, gates are places where decisions are taken. Gates are seats of legalities where they make decisions. Don't forget in Acts chapter 12, when Peter was come out of prison in verse 10, then the Bible says he came to an iron gate. Acts chapter 3 verse 1, there was a man by the beautiful gate. Genesis 22:17, thy seed shall possess the gates. There is always a gate.
You're too important.
And if you watch further, he says, he went further to say, and the voice spoke, he said, who is this king of glory? Meaning there was somebody manning the gate. Who is this king? So the great man has what?
The grands ont une
porte. Every great man has what? A gate man.
Une porte.
So you will pray today. The gates.
C'est la porte.
That needs to be lifted for you to gain access into tangible testimony.
Pour que j'ai accès au témoin.
Lift up your hands, oh ye gates.
Soyez levé.
The gate of my success. The gate preventing my rising. Lift up your head. It's a command. As you are praying, you are not negotiating, you are giving command. There's prayer of inquiry, there's prayer of supplication. There's prayer of intercession. There's prayer of praise. There's prayer of worship. There's prayer of command. This is a command. That's you are making, command. And when you are giving command, you don't give command on your knees. So this is not a prayer you pray kneeling down. You give command on your what? So this is not a prayer you kneel down. Lift up your head, don't you get? Lift up your head. No. Is a command. Are you ready? Say, my father, my father.
Mon père.
Shout it loud and clear.
Mon père.
As I begin to pray, as I begin to pray, I speak to the forces.
I speak to the forces
contending my next level.
Contending my next level.
Lift up your head.
Lift up your head.
Oh, ye gates.
Oh, ye gates.
Of my destiny.
Of my
open your mouth and fire prayer.
My father, my father. As I begin to
fire prayer.
Lift up your head. Oh, ye gates of my destiny. Lift up your head. Oh, ye gates of my destiny. Yeah,
into hell. And he say, I'm being lifted, ye everlasting doves. Another translation will say, ye ancient doves. Everlasting doors mean doors, or ancient doors means doors that were shut against your father, shut against your mother, doors that have been shut against others before you. These are doors that they try to access and they never access. Am I communicating? And so this, what prayer is this? That the doors that closed against my forefathers, the doors that closed against my grandfather,
comme un grand-père,
the doors that were shut against others before me,
fermé contre les autres avant moi,
they will open to you.
Ils vont s'ouvrir.
I said they will open to you. That's what restoration. That's what restoration is all about.
La restauration.
Accessing the very things that escaped others. The success, the achievement, the breakthroughs they couldn't handle in their time, you assess them. Lift up your right hand on fire.
Say, my father, my father.
My father, my father.
Shout it loud and clear.
My father, my father.
Let the devil hear your voice.
My father, my father.
As I begin to pray.
Excellent is your power. Excellent is your power.
Lift your hands up. I believe in miracles. Lift your hands. Lift your hands. I believe in miracles. I've seen a soul set free. Miraculous, a changing one, revealed through Calvary. And I see the lilies push its way up through the stubborn side. And I believe in miracles, and I believe in God. And I see the lilies push its way up through the stubborn side, and I believe in miracles, for I believe in God. Holy, holy, holy are you, Lord. Heavens and angels bow.
The heavens and angels bow.
The redeemed we worship you.
The redeemed we worship you.
Holy, holy are you, Lord.
Holy, holy, holy are you.
Sing it one more time, loud and clear. Jesus' name. Take your seats. God bless you. Makobolodo Biligitus Igede. Daniel chapter 10. Mosege. Daniel. Chapter 10, we read 12 and 13. Daniel chapter 10, 12, 13. Have you found it? Then said he unto me, fear not, Daniel, for from the first day that thou didst set thy heart to understand and to chasten thyself before thy God, thy words were heard. I have come for thy words. But, somebody say but, the prince of the kingdom of Persia withstood me 120 days. But lo, somebody say but, Michael, one of the chief princes, came to help me and remained there with the kings of Persia. With the kings. I want to share what I titled, when your answer is in between. Tell your neighbor, when your answer is in between. There are people who have been praying for years. There are people who have been fasting. There are people who have been asking God for certain things in their life. And sometimes God, when he hears them pray and ask him, God is a little bit surprised, because what they are asking for has already been released from heaven, but on earth it has not landed. They are saying, why is this testimony not here? And God is asking, why are they still asking me for this thing? Because I have released it. It has been released, but it's not here, because it is in between. There are people whose wedding and people whose celebration of marriage has already been released from heaven, but on earth they are not enjoying it. There are people whose miracle babies have been released from heaven, but on earth they are not enjoying it. There are people whose prosperity have been released from heaven, but on earth they are not enjoying it, because it is, I come with an assignment. My assignment this morning is to release upon the earth that testimony that is hanging in the atmosphere. My assignment this morning is to release upon you that your breakthrough that is pending, that your answer that is pending, every request that you have called upon God about that is hanging in the atmosphere, I release it in Jesus' name. I release it in Jesus' name. I release it in Jesus' name. Somebody shout fire. Take your seat. I want to announce to you, take your seat if you can, that that which you have been asking God for is no more in heaven. It has been released, but it's in between. That is why you are asking, is God deaf? Is God not hearing my prayers? How come these miracles are not forthcoming? God is saying, no, I'm not a God whose hand is shut. I'm not a God for me to lie. The answer has been released. It's no more my responsibility. It's been released. It's up to you. Kalabo Shaka. And I want to announce to somebody here, no matter the number of testimonies hanging in the atmosphere, I activate it down upon your life. I say, activate it down upon your life. God wants you. Study your Bible. If you study your Bible, you will see progressional movement. You will see speedy acceleration. There were different mountains that represented different dimensions. You are supposed to have graduated beyond the level of asking into the level of fellowshipping. How come for the past 10 years you are still prayer request, and the past 20 years you are still carrying prayer request, the past 50 years you are still asking? At this point it should be fellowship. The Old Testament Christianity was in Mount Sinai. Was the place of demand, but the New Testament Christianity is in Mount Zion, the place of possessing your possession. We have moved from Sinai, we have moved into Zion. Am I talking to somebody here? It's not the generation of asking, it's the generation of that I may know him and the power of his resurrection. Is the generation of, Lord, what do you want me to do for you? Not what you want to do for me, what you want me to do for you. People were looking for anointing, yet a woman anointed Jesus. People are looking for God to anoint them, yet a woman broke an alabaster box of ointment and anointed Jesus. You can't be neutral in the kingdom of God. If you cannot bring money, bring souls. You can't bring money, win souls. I have nothing to give you, but shut up! What kind of wizardry songs are those? I have nothing to give you but to thank you. And you are singing me with so much zeal. I have something.
nothing to give you. I may not have a car, but I can preach to somebody. I'm looking for people that will say every month at least 5 souls must follow me to church. Not you asking God, not you placing the man. Am I talking to somebody right now?
My birthday is in 2 months' time, and the Lord was asking me questions when I was in Port Harcourt. In the morning, the second morning, I was just worshiping God, and God asked me a question. And he said, it's well. God never tells you you have done well. God never tells you you have done well. When you have done commendable, God tells you it is well, to make you know you are on track. And the Lord said to me, what do you want me to do for you? And I said to him, nothing. And he said, you don't need anything. I said, nothing. All I want, strength, zeal, grace, souls. And everyone was quiet. This morning, some ministers, 3, while we were talking, the Lord said to me, because you have asked for souls and asked for zeal for my work, he said, in the dimension of the miraculous, people are about to start asking questions that what is going on in the dimension of the miraculous. He said, people will say, get ready, son, this year. He said, they will so criticize you. They will try to analyze you. He said, not just for prophecy this time, but for the level of miracles. He said, because there are people that will stand as they are standing. Operations will take place in their body. There are missing parts of the body that will be restored. There are strange miracles that will happen. Am I talking to somebody right now? What am I talking about? Not give me. What can I do for the kingdom? You have been asking for long, and your answer has been released. But something is suspending it in the atmosphere today. It is released by fire.
I have
a few things to touch. Take your seat. I've got to work with time.
How do I bring down?
Please follow me closely.
My answer
that is in between.
Number one,
you must be a Daniel. Somebody shout, be a Daniel. What is the meaning of that? Daniel means God is the judge.
Before God will judge your enemies,
he must first judge your life.
It is if you pass the judgment of God that God will now decide to judge your enemies. What made Daniel stand out? What made Daniel a man who in his time shook his generation? What made it happen like that?
See how the Bible started it. The Bible says, and this Daniel proposed, Daniel chapter 1, verse 8,
in his heart,
that he will not defile himself with the king's meat. If you want to be a Daniel, there are 4 things you must do. Number one, have a mind of your own.
Have a mind of your own. Any man that is easily influenced negatively cannot take his word by storm. You are not dressing funny. Now you just got a few friends, you have changed dressing. You are easily influenced. There are things you will not do just because you got new friends. The things you hated before, and the people influence you anyhow. You cannot influence your world. If you must influence your world, you must be a man who people negatively can hardly influence. You don't dress because people are dressing that way. You don't speak because they speak that way. You don't act because they act that way. Am I talking to somebody? That everybody around you is doing something wrong does not make it right. Have a mind of your own. Daniel proposed in his heart. He proposed in his heart that
listen to me very well.
You can never
say they pushed me to doing it. You did what you wanted to do. Nobody pushed you. Nobody influenced you. Nobody cajoled you. Nobody convinced you.
Anything you did in life that's negative,
you wanted to do it. I wish I was saying something.
And Daniel proposed.
Watch me. Let me tell you what that chapter 1 is all about. The king, they brought some exiles from Babylon, into Babylon, from Israel. And the king of Babylon needed men who are well built. The kind of men with all their biceps and triceps that when they walk into the palace, when you see them, you get scared. So he needed to groom them, and he gave them a particular diet to build them up. But those diets were not the kind of diet that Israel were allowed to eat. Because the king's meal, the king wanted to achieve something. So he said, give them this, give them this, give them that. So when they brought the meal before Daniel knew that in Israel, this was against the laws of God. So what did he do? He said, I'm not going to eat this. He said, but you, if you look sickly, in fact, the man who was in charge of their welfare was panicking that Daniel should not appear looking sick, because Daniel brought vegetables. He said, I'll eat vegetables and I'll get the same result. So the man was scared, because the king unpicked men who will stand before the palace. Daniel was one of them. So when Daniel picked vegetables and all, he said to himself, no way, no matter how the king wants me to appear before the world, I will not defy myself with his meat. The Bible says, after a long while, when they brought all of them, those they ate the king's meal, Daniel took vegetables and peppers. It was not the meal that made them flourish, it was peppers. The Bible says, when they all stood, Daniel looked well fed, looked better than all of them. Why? A man with purpose, if you pursue purpose, no matter what others pursue, at the end of the day, you stand out. You have nothing that's guarding your life. You just wake up, you sleep, you wake up. There's no focus for your life. I told you, if you don't live a life of urgency, you fall into people's emergencies. Say that to your neighbor. If you don't live a life of urgency, you fall into people's emergencies. Daniel proposed in his heart that he will not defile himself with the king's meat. You must get to a point as a woman that if that you have 5 tenants in a compound does not mean everybody must be your friend. That we live, that we are co-tenants doesn't mean we are colleagues. That we are in the same office doesn't make us friends. You are a pastor, I'm a pastor. That doesn't make us friends. Am I communicating? It doesn't make us friends. So you must get that point in life where you must have a mind of your own. Please don't let people cajole and convince you. When you see what is wrong, don't say it is right because others say it is right. If it's wrong, stand on your ground and say it is wrong. In a department is doing the wrong thing doesn't mean you should join them. Tell somebody you have a mind of your own. Say that again. One more time. You don't really know why you are alive until you know how to live. You don't really know why you are living until you know how to live. The second thing about Daniel that made Daniel bring answers that were suspended in between. If you study your Bible in Daniel chapter 6 verse 3, the Bible says, and this Daniel had an excellent spirit. He was preferred. Number two, Daniel was a man of excellence. If you must be a Daniel, you must be a man of excellence. What is excellence? Excellence is doing something common in an uncommon way. Am I talking to somebody? When you do something that looks common in such a way that stands out. There is a way a man can give an offering in an excellent way. There's a way a man can package his offering. He's coming to church, he looks for crisp notes. He looks for new notes and he packages them. That is excellence in giving. Excellence. Not squeeze one thing somewhere, bring it from one wrapper in now wear something. Excellence. You are going to church and you keep the best clothes for church. Excellence. The best clothes for church. There are people, if they are going for a job interview, when you see the way they are dressed, you are surprised. When they come to church, they are so casual. Very casual. They say, God, check the heart.
He said, God checks the heart.
When you come to church, you meet God and you meet man. You must have the spirit of excellence. You don't just walk into a church, a place that's dirty, that's looking stinky, and you say, well, no. Everyone, you don't say you are not in a sanctuary department. If you see anywhere dirty, clean it up. That's excellence. Excellence! Doing something common in an uncommon way.
Am I communicating here? Am I communicating? So please, I want to advise you. When it comes to God, do it with value. Do it with respect. Do it with reverential fear. When it comes to God, there are things you shouldn't give to God as seed. You should be scared. I've told you the story of a pastor who was taking his bath one time, and a lady brought a goat to his house as a seed and tied it behind the house. The goat was blind in one eye. So the pastor was praying, and the woman said, Daddy, I brought a goat for you. The pastor said, no problem. May the Lord bless you according to what you brought. And the lady said, God forbid. Why? Because she knew the implication of that prayer. There are people, I see what they call sacrifice is an aggrandized insult to God. A message is going on, somebody just run out of zeal and drop one dead handset. He says, it's moved. You should be removed. What dead answer that is faulty that he cannot even use? All the numbers and have wiped off, and he tied it with rubber. The screen broken. Even as he dropped the phone, he kept the charger. And I wonder, I said, are you not afraid? God deserves the best. You want to give God a phone? Buy a new one, not a used one. Don't give God what you have used. God does not need second hand. Stop carrying used handsets to God. Keep it, it's not needed. Am I talking there? God, value God, excellence. Am I talking to somebody here? Have you seen Thanksgiving? They are doing Thanksgiving. That's when people change money to smaller denominations. They think they are smart. You call them 20 times, they come out, put one small thing in an envelope, and they are dancing out. And I look at them. But when they are spraying during wedding, they look for clean notes. Am I saying the truth? Look for clean currency. What is God talking about? God is saying that if you must get to that point where you can bring answers down, you must serve God with a mindset of excellence. Sometimes when my media people call me, say, Papa, we there's this thing we want to buy. There's this thing we want to buy. I say, how much is it? They tell me. What does it do? They tell me. But there's another one that is lesser. That's like, hey, we can't do lesser. If it's for me, do lesser. If it's for God, they brought cameras. They said this one is 450. What, some time back? This one is this. This one is 1 point. So I said, give us that one that is 1 point. Sister, you didn't hear the amount. I said, it doesn't matter. Give us that one. That one is the best. Serve God with the mindset of giving him the best. Am I talking here? Give God the best. Let that be your mentality. Now you are coming to church, is the best. You are giving an offering, is the best. You are thanking God, is the best. The best. The best. The best. Something that cost you something. Not you carry one dead, frustrated piece of yam and half bag of rice. And you are coming to church, you are dancing. Say, this is my widow's mite. Are you a widow? Number three. To be Daniel, you must understand the principle of service. Somebody say service. I'm going to do more of teaching. I need you to follow me closely. You must understand the principle of service.
If you study Daniel, Daniel was the only man that was relevant in four governments. He so served and served and served that they saw his relevance. Every king that became king, a king is in the bracket of a president today. Every king that became a king, because of Daniel's heart to serve, selfless service, every king that became a king sent for Daniel.
He started with Nebuchadnezzar. Is that true? He moved to Belshazzar. He moved to Darius. He moved to Cyrus.
Four.
Imagine a man being vice president in four governments. If he had nothing he brought on the table, nobody wants him again.
For a man to be called on board, every government calls him on board, it means there was something unique about him. There was four governments. The man was relevant. If you study the Bible, he was relevant in Nebuchadnezzar, chapter 1 to chapter 4 of Daniel. Belshazzar, he was relevant. Chapter 5, chapter 7, chapter 8. For Darius, chapter 6, chapter 9. For Cyrus, chapter 10 to 12. For four governments, anytime they needed an assistant, they called Daniel. Why?
He served selflessly, not looking for what he can get. Selflessly.
When a man is selfless, he's relevant. When a man is out and is thinking of what he can put on the table, he's relevant.
When you work with somebody in your office who is a boss, think of what you can bring to the company, not what you can always collect. Am I communicating? There are ways to follow great men and they trust you. You have a boss in the office who is telling you, run there and just get something. Run to Benin and get something. And you have money to fuel the car personally. Don't collect from him. That's wisdom. Because such men, no matter what you give them, they already have. Those little favors are what make them trust you. Oh, you're not getting what I'm talking about. Those little favors. Say, rush to Benin. You need for... No, sir. I can handle that. You're gone. He's not stupid. He's watching you. Oh, you're back. Somebody comes to see him. The person needs a stiffer. Say, come, let me. No, sir. I'll take care of him. The man is watching you. That thing you are doing is more than millions if you are giving it to him by cash. Those little favors. He now understands that you have taken him like family. I wish I was talking to somebody here. Not this one. They send you on errand. You keep the change. You think people are stupid? They send and then you come back. Say, how much do you buy newspaper?
2,000.
The man is watching. He's quiet. And at the end of the day, because he knows you are conscious of self, you are conscious of what you can get, you are conscious of what you can grab.
Am I communicating here? There are people that have lost opportunities because of little greed. Major doors have been closed. Major opportunities have been lost. Why? Because of greed. Anytime you are set on errand, anytime you see an opportunity, you want to make money, you want to make profit, you want to get something, you want to commercialize, you want to merchandise.
Tell somebody, be selfless.
Say it aloud, say be selfless. Say be selfless. Say be selfless. Say be selfless.
Daniel was fearless. Number four, Daniel was fearless. Fearless. A word was spoken that nobody should pray.
That for 1 month, nobody should pray. Daniel said, for what?
Child of God, let me say this to you, and don't ever forget this. Anything that threatens your prayer life, fight it.
Something can threaten every other thing and you keep quiet. But when it has to do with your prayer life, fight it publicly.
You didn't hear what I said?
If something is threatening your prayer life, you can no more pray because somebody
into your house. You can no more pray because somebody is quarreling with you. You can no more pray because of this, because of that. Fight it. Contend with it. Because whatever fights your prayer life wants to destroy your destiny. Whatever fights your prayer life wants to ruin your future. Whatever fights your prayer life wants to take you back for good. Whatever fights your prayer life wants to keep you on the spot. Whatever fights your prayer life wants to make you incapacitated. Whatever fights your prayer life wants to make you stranded. Anything against your prayer life, you must stand against it. Am I talking to somebody here? If something has affected you, that because of that involvement, you can no more pray, you can no more fast. Fight it.
Fight it. Can I go on? Number two. I told you I'm working with time.
To bring down the blessing that is in between.
Angelic assistance. Now, listen to me. Just put angelic assistance. Don't write you need or you must have. Just put angelic and I will explain to you. When I say angelic assistance, I'm not just talking about you being assisted by angels. I'm talking about your angels being assisted. Not you being assisted by angels, but your angels being. I'm going to tell you a few things about angels that many of you do not know.
Who are angels? Angels.
The word angel means messenger. That's what it means, messengers. Angels are spiritual beings, but they have human form. Can I repeat that? Angels are spiritual beings, but they have what? Human form. They eat. You forget the Bible says, which of you did eat angels' food? They eat. They move with speed. But let me tell you something about angels. How to assess angels before I now tell you how your angels can get assistance. If you must command angels naturally as a Christian, what I'm going to say, you might be deep. I'll show you from scriptures. If you command angels naturally, Hebrews 1:14. Are there not ministering spirits sent for to minister to them who shall become heirs of salvation? What guarantee you to the ministry of angels is salvation. If you are not saved, you have no angel. What you have around is a demon. Hello? Ask somebody, are you saved? Ask someone, are you saved?
What guarantees you? Now, the next one is Psalm 34, verse 7. The angel of the Lord encamped round about them that feared God and delivered them. Now, the first thing is, when you get born again, you are entitled to angels.
But that does not make them surround you to protect you. What makes angels surround you permanently to protect you is how much fear you have for God. Psalm 34, 7. The angel of the Lord encamped round about them that feared God and delivered them.
But the place we read from, when Daniel was praying, as Daniel was praying, the Bible says that Gabriel, who stands in the presence of God, Gabriel, who stands in God's throne, if you study your Bible before you get to chapter 10, if you read chapter 8, you read from verse 16 down, you would have seen Gabriel in operation. Gabriel was already around. Gabriel was around with the good news. Gabriel did not come from heaven when Daniel was praying. It was Michael that came. Gabriel was around. If you check chapter 8, you see Gabriel in operation. Chapter 9, chapter 10, Gabriel was around. Am I talking to somebody? He was already around that land. But on his way to give Daniel the answer, he was intercepted.
Gabriel and Michael are the two archangels. They are not just angels. Those are people that have been angels before God from creation. Hello? Let me shock you.
Gabriel and Michael are the two. Gabriel, Michael is one of the princes, the chief princes.
If you read chapter 12 of Genesis 1, that Michael of Daniel chapter 12 verse 1, that Michael is the prince in charge of Israel, God's people. But let me shock you. On the day of judgment, when the trumpet shall sound before the rapture, God is not going to come as the Lord Jesus until these two angels, their voice will first be heard before the trumpet. It is Michael
angel and Gabriel
that will precede the coming of Christ. 1 Thessalonians chapter 4. 1 Thessalonians chapter 4. 1 Thessalonians chapter 4. 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verse 16. 1 Thessalonians 4, verse 16. For the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout and with the voice of what? The archangel. Who is the archangel? Michael and Gabriel.
So when the Lord is on his way, there will be a shout of the angels who blow the alarm. After they blow the alarm, the next you now hear is the trumpet.
They are not to blow the trumpet of Christ coming. They are to blow the sound before the trumpet will sound. Shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel, and with the trump of God. The angels shout, saying it is time. Then the Lord blows the trumpet. So you see how important these angels are? And yet, one of them was stopped.
One of them
was stopped. Intercepted. These are angels that have been angels from Genesis. These are angels that have been angels before the foundation of the world. Am I communicating?
And when they stopped Gabriel, Michael, now,
to show you how important angels are, even God needed angels to reply Satan.
When the devil rebelled, when the devil reacted against God, it wasn't God that fought back. It was the angel. Angel Michael led other angels and put the devil down. Am I talking to somebody? Why was it easy for Angel Michael to put,
imagine, Angel Gabriel was stopped. This time, Angel Michael put the devil and other angels down. I will show you why. It goes to number three. Number three, if you must bring answers in between, you must understand the mystery of territorial operations. Somebody said territorial operations.
Why was it easy for Michael to bring down the devil?
Because it was in heaven. That was God's territory.
But if you study your Bible, you discover the Persian king.
Let me tell you something about princes. Now the devil, whether you like it or not, if you read Matthew chapter 4, when Satan was taking the Lord around during temptation, he said, all of this kingdom is mine. Worship me and I will give you. Jesus did not argue. Why? Because Jesus knew that Satan was not wrong. Because 2 Corinthians 10 calls the devil the god of this world. Adam handed it over to him. It's only us who are redeemed by the second Adam that have taken it back from him.
But for the world, for those of the world, those of the world is their god. Why we have advantage over him is that we are in the world, but we are not of the world. Territorial. Every nation, Satan plants princes. Satan programs people. Ladies and gentlemen, if you come from a location, a family where everybody dies and everybody struggles in poverty, there is a prince of poverty in that family, and you need angels to combat and stop that prince from holding your prosperity. Every family has a prince. When you contend with a prince, the kings will come out.
Verse 13. Bring verse 13 again. Daniel chapter 10. Daniel chapter 10. Verse 13. Let me show you. Daniel 10, 13. Listen. But the prince of the kingdom of Persia withstood me 120 days. But lo, Michael, one of the chief princes, came to help me. I remained there with the king. The prince fought me. But I stayed back with the kings. In other words, I went to help Daniel. I went to help Gabriel to contend the prince of Persia. I brought angelic reinforcement. While I was contending the prince and I defeated him, they went for demonic reinforcement. The kings now came. Are you picking something here? I started a battle with the prince, but I was left with the kings.
All the kings of Persia came out
and they began to fight. If you study the end verse, the last verse, I think verse 20 or 21, I don't know, of Daniel chapter 10, after he was through, Daniel chapter 10, the end verse, after he was through with Daniel, chapter 21, okay, he said, I will show thee. Is that the last verse? Go to 20, verse 20. He said, then said he, knowest thou, wherefore I come unto thee. Now I will return to fight. I came to give you this message. The battle has not ended. I am going back. Guess what he said? He said, fight with the prince of Persia. When I am gone forth, the prince of Grecia will come. In other words, Israel was to be dominated by two nations, Persia and Greece. So in other words, Daniel, this battle, I have fought with the prince of Persia. You are about to pray for Greece. Understand, there is another prince that is holding Greece. I'm not coming here, Yabashaba. There is another prince that is holding the territory of Greece. After Persia goes, the prince of Greece will come. Are you picking something here? So that tells you that in a family, the prince controlling your family may not be the prince controlling my family. There is Persia, there is Greece. The prince control, there are families today. Nobody prosper. You want to be the first to break forth, your angels need assistance. Am I talking to somebody here? You want to be the first person to stand up in that family and get out of local prosperity and get out of local success. You want to become an international voice. You want to have wealth in your life. You want to be protected. You want to be preserved. You want to live long. If you're in that category, I came to pray that your angels will be assisted. Say, my angel, carry my blessing. Receive divine backup. 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 There are certain compounds, when you park in there, what others are suffering, you start suffering. There are certain houses, when you park into those houses, if you went there with two cars, you lose all. If you enter there, your children were brilliant, before you know it, their brain is corrupted. Because there's a power over that territory. There are people who can succeed in a particular area where they have a shop, but when they relocate to another place, 1 month, 2 months, they won't sell. Because there's a territorial demonic operations. There are some of you were doing well until you started hanging around certain people. The kind of dreams you were not seeing before, you started seeing such dreams. The kind of things that were not happening to you began to happen. I came to attack territorial powers. I came to attack territorial oppression. I came to attack the powers that have stopped others in that family. You are breaking record. Sit down. Are you ready to pray? There was a lady, a young girl, many years ago, in the 60s. She was working with white men, and she was so nice to them. So they decided they were going to take her abroad when they are going back. She had good character, so they said they'll take her abroad. She decided to take a leave and go and tell her parents. Her father and her mother were suspicious of the white men. So they took a substance and rubbed her and made some incantation that she would never travel. She didn't know that was what they did, what they were making incantation. Those of you who were going to herbalist, herbalist will rub something and start talking. You don't know what he's saying. He's talking. Whether he's placing curses on your life, you don't know. He's making incantation. Incantation are not English you can understand. They make certain gibberish, jam them together and say certain things you don't know. Most of those incantations, gods are being called. They are calling spirits to bear witness. That is why after you, now you are born again, those statements that were made were covenants. How do you break those covenants that you didn't understand when the man was saying? You must also speak a language that you too, you don't understand. I'm talking to somebody now. If you must cancel, if you must stop the language that you don't understand, you must speak a language that they also do not. That's why I'm beating you. If you don't speak in tongues. I pity any Christian who does not speak in tongues. Anywhere I enter, if I sit in the plane, you know I'm a pastor. Because I'm sitting, as I'm sitting down, Rakapune Likera Bayata. Anywhere I enter. You see, they walk up to me. You're a man of God. I say, yes. How do you know? See, the kind of things that you said when you sat down just now. I need this one. It's not just a church goer. As I sit down, Lebo, Niko, Sing, Bara, Gede, Doro, Gede, Totale, Bale, Bara, Bara, Bara. Now, am I talking to somebody here? Every time, you must learn to pray in the Holy Ghost. Paul said to them, have you received, Acts chapter 19, verse 2, have you received the Holy Ghost since you believe? And they say, we don't know whether there's any Holy Ghost. And he said, unto what baptism were you baptized? They were saying, oh, of Paul. He said, no, that's not the kind of baptism. There's a baptism of the Holy Ghost. He handles issues that you can't understand. Kalatayebo. I hear people say that you have to be led to speak in tongues. You don't need to be led. The day the Holy Ghost entered you, the leading to speak in tongues entered you. There's no special leading. They say, don't speak it out. Just be careful. Speak. No! So I pity you if you don't pray in the Holy Ghost. Let me ask your neighbor, have you received the Holy Ghost? Take your seat. Can I go on? Can I go on? So now Daniel was in Persia. You know, physical presence in a territory makes you a victim of that territory. Either your physical presence there or your presence by covenant. What is covenant? Marriage. When you marry a woman, what follow our family start following you. If you can't address it, you end up a victim. Have you not seen people that marry into families where the people always lose their husbands? Huh? They end up also being lost at a young age. Have you not seen family where they enter, no matter how rich the men were, they become poor? You don't understand this thing now. Christians are the set of people that don't take records. Go to the bank. There are transactions of 5 years ago. They still have it on record. Go to the court. Then if you want to find out certain things, you go to the court. There are people that keep records. Church. One of the strength of the old court is record. Instruction. A man is occultic. They want to make him wealthy. They will tell him, don't enter one room in your house. Nobody. The man will tell his wife, do not enter. Instruction. But Christians, don't go there. He wants to go to know why they say shouldn't go. The pastor says,
say don't travel.
Why won't I travel? I'm covered with the blood of Jesus. I gave an instruction one time in this church. I said that week nobody should travel. You remember? I said nobody should travel. People are confused. As if you live in town here, don't travel. And somebody needed to go for a wedding, a marriage, something, and traveled. Do you remember the story? The death was painful.